The answer is the third choice, that the client should send the random value encrypted using the server's public key. Both of the first two options assume that the client and server already share a symmetric key. If this was the case, well, they wouldn't need this whole protocol. They could use that symmetric key right away to start communicating. And the fact that they're able to communicate using that key verifies that they have authenticated each other. This solution does not work well for web applications. There's no way for me to easily establish a shared symmetric key with Amazon before the protocol begins. The fourth choice would be useful for integrity. If the server knew the client's public key, then it could verify that this random value came from the client, but this would expose the random value to anyone else who intercepted the message and also knows the client's public key. And it provides no authentication that the server is who the client expects. So the right answer is the third one, that we want to send the random value encrypted so it can't be intercepted, but that it can be decrypted by the server, and the server has the corresponding private key to decrypt this. Now, once the server receives this message, it can decrypt it using its private key. We'll use the value of R as a session key. And after this, both the client and the server have the shared session key and can communicate. Now we have a secure channel between the client and the server, encrypted with the symmetric key K.